its loyal companion in its endless celestial journey, sometimes seems like a white dot in the dark pages of the universe.
What is that mysterious bright object that illuminates our dark nights? Man has always been interested in finding that out.
In 1865, Jules Verne, an inspired pioneer, wrote a book about his wish to discover the mysteries of the moon. He wanted to launch himself with a huge cannon towards the moon in some sort of a spaceship.
For the next 104 years, his ideas continued to inspire the next generations, which ultimately led to one of mankind's biggest breakthroughs.
It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
With this short walk on the moon, a new era in science started. We finally could get a little closer to the origin of the moon. Over the years, four theories have been stated on how the moon was actually formed.
One of the theories that could explain the formation of the moon is the co-formation hypothesis. This hypothesis states that the Earth and the moon were formed together at the same time and place from a protoplanetary disk. A protoplanetary disk is a flat, thin, pizza-like disk that forms around young stars. Within this disk, dust and ice grains accrete into larger particles. This process continues until planet-sized objects are formed.
The co-formation hypothesis is still considered possible. However, some scientists didn't believe in this theory and kept on searching for other explanations.
A second theory about the origin of the moon is the so-called fission hypothesis. The theory states that in the early years of planet Earth, the rotation of the Earth was so fast that a massive piece of Earth crust let loose and spun into the atmosphere. Eventually, this massive piece of rock got into an orbit around planet Earth and formed the moon. However, as other theories started to appear, scientists decided to keep on investigating other possibilities.
Investigating the moon in more detail, scientists found that the chemical and physical properties of the moon differed extremely compared to the planet Earth. The iron content of the moon was much lower than the iron content in the Earth's crust, and that caused a problem. When comparing the physical features of the moon and the Earth, there is no evidence of plate tectonics. This may indicate that the moon is and always was a solid rock. The Earth, however, does show physical features that indicate plate tectonics. These differences made some scientists believe that the moon is a giant piece of space debris that was captured in a gravitational orbit around the planet Earth. There is, however, one slight problem with this theory. When scientists analyzed the isotope composition of rocks from the moon and compared them to the isotope composition of the Earth, it showed a huge resemblance.
It seems as if a fourth theory was needed to explain that smiling bright object in the sky. And that's how I have Professor Carsten Dominic here to explain us the fourth theory. Welcome, Professor Dominic. Oh. The fourth theory, the giant impact hypothesis, how does that theory get us to the origin of the moon? How does it work?
Yeah, the giant impact theory is really an outrageous theory because it assumes that the moon was formed in the most gigantic collision which you can imagine, where the Earth is colliding with another planet, a planet which was as large as Mars is today.
Wow.
And that impacted on the Earth, and in the collision, enough material was thrown into an orbit around the Earth, and from that material the moon formed. That is the theory.
Is there actual evidence for this impact scenario?
Well, I mean, it started with the fact that all the other theories really had severe problems in explaining the origin of the moon. For example, the fission theory would expect much too fast rotation of the early Earth. It would have to have rotated very, very fast in order to spin off the moon in this way, and that's really against the evidence. We do know how fast the Earth has spun in the past, and it was faster, and it has been slowed down in the run of time, but not that fast.
Okay.
And also the other theories have problems.
Why is this giant impact hypothesis the most prevailing theory that's out there?
One of the most important things is that the chemical composition of the moon as a whole is completely different from what we know from the Earth. Okay. Because the Earth has a big core, which is almost half the radius of the Earth in size. It's very big, and that core is entirely made of iron.
Okay.
And if you had the Moon and the Earth form in a similar way, you would expect that the distribution between iron and silicates would be approximately the same. But looking at the Moon has hardly any core, so it's very iron poor. And a good way to explain this would be to make the Moon out of the crust of the Earth. That would be true for the fission theory, but
mm-hmm.
there is a problem with the angular momentum. But it would certainly work for the impact theory.
Okay, and the conformation hypothesis that the Moon and Earth are formed at the same time?
That is clearly in contradiction with the low metal abundance of the Moon.
Okay.
So I think that the Moon would really have a similar amount of iron as the Earth has, if that was the case.
Does this hypothesis also have some difficulties in explaining the origin of the Moon?
Well, there's certainly difficulties. The first difficulty is that you have to ask yourself, is it actually likely that something like this happens? Of course, we don't have many cases, so we cannot really estimate how likely it is. It may be a singular event in the entire universe. We don't really know this. But that's, of course, is a problem. So do these collisions actually occur? Then there's also some problems explaining how big the impact has to be, because depending on the model, it actually has to be even bigger than Mars, maybe even bigger than the Earth in order to make it work. But there are still uncertainties in these models.
Okay.
And so, yes, there are small hiccups, but I think it's clear this is the theory which comes closest to explain all the evidence which we have.
The Moon is an integral part of life on Earth and has affected evolution and the ecosystems for billions of years because of the Sun's reflect. The Moon affects the tides, animal behavior, plants, and we're on the verge of discovering a correlation between the Moon and earthquakes, as well as the Moon and human behavior. The giant impact hypothesis suggests that Earth and Moon are part of one another, and even if the hypothesis cannot be proven, or even if it's wrong, the Moon will always be a vital part of life on Earth.